Hey everyone, welcome to Binge Bar. Before we begin here, does anybody remember Kevin from Old Yeller? Well, if you don't, poor Kevin had to put down his beloved town due to rabies. And while that is one of the most saddest eye-watering moments in cinematography, the moral of the movie is that if you truly love something or someone, you must let it go. The Phil Kessel trade is inevitable, and it's going to happen this offseason. It's not a question of if he'll be traded, it's a question of where the great Phil the Thrill will be shipped off to. It was nice while it lasted, Pittsburgh, but the party's over. As the Stanley Cup comes to a close, we approach what will be one of the most interesting offseasons anyone has ever seen. We have just about every big name player a free agent, and the ones that aren't seem to want to be traded. There are numerous teams in rebuilds, and some of the grittiest and well-rounded units of teams we've seen over the past couple of seasons seem to have dwindled down to dust. For instance, the LA Kings and the Chicago Blackhawks dominated the hockey world for quite some time. This year they were a shadow of what they were. Same goes for the Pittsburgh Penguins. At least they made the playoffs, though. It was short-lived because they were swept by the New York Islanders. But this team has suffered multiple bad signings and horrible trades that turned the former back-to-back champions into a complete scramble of chaos. Who's to blame? While the trades were made by their GM, Jim Rutherford, the blood soaks in the hands of their coach, Mike Sullivan. No matter who you sign, what you trade away, you are still coaching a team with the talents of Sidney Crosby and of Evgeny Malkin, let alone Chris Letang, Phil Kessel, and even Matt Murray. There was no excuse whatsoever for the performance of this team last season, and now it's time for an answer. Sully refused to change his coaching style despite the rapid change in game, and it resulted in a harsh relationship between him and Phil Kessel. Of course, that's no secret, though, because as I stated before, Old Yeller. In this case scenario, however, Kevin is the fans of the Pittsburgh Penguins. Yeller will serve as Phil, while Mike Sullivan is the USM 1873 Trapdoor Springfield Rifle locked and loaded. That's just my thoughts. I'm not trying to point fingers here, but Sully is the one pointing the gun, and has for quite some time now. So as of today, where does Kessel go after all of this? There was a trade earlier in the week of the time of this recording that Pittsburgh and Minnesota had a perfect deal on the table. Jason Zucker, along with Victor Rask and a couple of picks, would be sent to the Berg for Kessel and the horrid contract of Jack Johnson. Kessel, however, refused to waive his no-trade clause. The problem with this is now his value on the market has dropped since the news released about this, at least according to some sources. It's going to be more difficult now for the Pens to get a fair value back for Phil. So with that being said, from here on out, all you can do is speculate, and that's really what the premise of today's video will cover. But before we even get to that, the only other known fact on all of this is that Kessel wants to play for the Arizona Coyotes head coach, Rick Tocchet. Sending Kessel to Arizona is what I've predicted for the last two seasons, and I'm still going to stand by it. Problem with that is, Arizona can't really build a fair trade for Pittsburgh to get a solid return. So realistically, this trade is probably off the table. With his value drifting due to Minnesota, though, something between the Pens and Yotes could just happen. Although, if Arizona is willing to part ways with Christian Dvorak and maybe a pick or two, this could still happen. Arizona knows they have the upper hand here on the Pens, so if they want Phil, they can get him. Other than Arizona, another great Western market for Kessel could be Colorado. The Avs could definitely use more scoring from their lines other than their first, including maybe Nikita Zadorov and a 2019 first-round pick that could land them Phil. A lot of fans are pointing to New Jersey and New York for a Phil Kessel trade. I have no confidence in him going to the Devils. Now that Zuccarello is in Dallas, I would also rule the Rangers out. That does leave one New York team still standing, though. The wild card to this offseason for the Penguins could be the Islanders. The Islanders are more than likely losing winger Jordan Eberle in free agency this season, and are in dire need of goal scorers. On top of that, they have more than enough salary cap space to sign whoever they want and then some. Even for the Pens, this trade would be great. New York has the picks and the youth that they could return. Dalcol, Bellows, Wallstrom, Soderstrom, and about 10 more names that are worth mentioning could satisfy the Pens' needs here. Personally, this trade would benefit both teams tremendously. Last season, I would have mentioned St. Louis here, but they are looking like they might not have trouble scoring goals anytime soon. With that being said, Carolina is always a contender for the Phil sweepstakes. Justin Falk's name is always on the table this time of year, and Carolina could compose a fairly amazing trade here for the Pens. And along with the New York Islanders, the Carolina Hurricanes also have a pretty decent package they could send out. It's also been rumored that the Nashville Predators have been interested in Kessel. And unlike most of the trades here, without doubt in my mind, this would have the biggest effect on the league. It would involve PK Subban and Michael Granlund for Phil Kessel, Ali Mahda, and Jack Johnson with a couple picks. The Pens could dispose of that horrible Johnson contract, dump Ali Mahda finally, and find the place Kessel's pretty fond of. They'd have a pretty decent return too. Subban is a great defender and would be a great addition to the blue line along Chris Letang. These are all just predictions though. Phil could easily go anywhere in the league. Especially with his value down right now, anything is possible. Pittsburgh is going to have a hard time moving him, don't get me wrong, but don't be surprised if he ends up in Buffalo or Vegas or even Dallas for that matter. It's going to be a crazy offseason, and all we can do is wait it out. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe for more content. Thank you. We'll see you next time.